went into the forest. He didn't know that the forest was enchanted. Some of the magic was good and some bad, to each as they deserved. Those who deserved good, the magic was good. Those who deserved bad, the magic was bad. Okay? Now, this forest was to remain enchanted until it was entered by someone who preferred his sorrows to all the joys of the world. You can stop.
Ješta volim da vas je puno. Dakle, počinjemo priču Šuma Striborova. It is a very good start of Stribor Forest that we are bringing to Spain. Šuma Striborova.
He didn't know that the forest was enchanted. Some of its magic was good and some was bad.
What a pretty snake! I'd like to take it home. Here's the silly fool who is going through. Mom, here's my wife. Thank God, my son.
Mom,
here's my wife.
Thank God, my son. But the mother was old and wise, and knew at once what's inside her daughter's mom's mouth. You have chosen a very pretty bride, but be careful, she could be a snake.
Oh, mother, how can you say so?
I hit. And there, do it
together.
Go.
Here is my wife.
Where is your wife?
ajde sad, uči, tu stojiš, ne daš. Tebe prvo namičnu. Tu stojiš i ne daš, je tako? Tebi ćeš se.
One day, a young man went into Stribor's forest. He did not know that the forest was enchanted. Some of its magic was good and some was bad. The young man sat and cut wood. It was a nice winter day. After some time, he sat down on a stump to rest. And out of the stump slipped a snake. This wasn't a real snake, but a human being transformed into a snake. Sparkled like silver in the sun.
What a pretty snake! I'd have to take it home!
Here's the silly fool who is going to help me out of my trouble.
A snake turned herself at once into a most beautiful lady standing there in front of the young man. The tongue in her mouth remained serpent's tongue.
Here I am! Take me home and marry me!
Okay, go with me home.
And now they all live with his old mother.
Vi vodite u kuću. Mom, here is my wife.
Thank God, my son.
But the mother was old and wise, and she knew at once what was inside her daughter-in-law's mouth.
You have chosen a very pretty bride, but be careful, she could be a snake.
Oh, mother, how you can say so? I hate you!
And three of them lived together. She was not a good person. She gave difficult tasks to mother, but fortunately, mother did all of them well. On the third day, the mother sat by fire and took up her son's shirt to mend it. When her daughter-in-law saw that, she flew at her, snatched the shirt out of her hands and screamed.
Stop that, you blind fool! It's none of your business!
The old woman cried, and she went outside.
my dear, I have no money, but if you like, I will mend your sleeve.
Alone at home, she decided to lit the fire. Suddenly, she heard a strange noise. It seemed the old woman were growing young again and laughed like a dove. She took hands with the brownies and danced. But the dance stopped at once.
To get rid of my daughter-in-law, please, please.
When the old woman had finished her story, one of the brownies called out, and his name was Malik Antilevich.
I will help you. I will go to the land and bring your magpies and switch them a chicken.
But in rain, mother was thrown out of her own house by her son.
So we're... Go out! Go out!
She was very miserable. She took the kindling wood out of her bag, scrapped the snow aside, and put a fire to warm herself. The brownies came out again. They came to Stribor's forest. At the start cried the old woman through the forest. Stribor was lord of that forest. In an oak there was so huge room for 7 golden castles. In front of the finest of the castles sat Stribor himself on a throne.
Do not worry, old woman. Cross the fence, cut the fence, and you'll be young again.
And what will become of my son?
Don't be silly. He won't be in your present life.
Oh no, I would rather be an old woman with my son than a young one without anyone.
Goodbye.
And the old woman went home.
Mom, Mom, please, can you forgive me?
I will forgive you, my son. Let go, please.
Some years later, the young man married that poor, sweet girl who brought the brownies to their house.
And
they all three lived happily together and after.
And that was the Stribor's forest.
I am a young man, I'm Milka.
I'm a six. I'm a snake and I'm black.
My name is Josef and I'm Stribor.
I'm Lucia and I am poor girl.
I'm Nina.
And I'm Kristen.
We are the narrators.
This is my colleague. Her name is teacher Nina Mijatović. And she is in charge of all these costumes and scenography. And I'm Xenia Vidna-Ninčević. I adapted Stribor in Stribor's Forest. Bye.